Hey, welcome to the second part where I have made quite a mistake. I will show you. Today we will be sculpting a body and a hair for our character. Let's go! Okay, let's start with neck. Press Shift A and the other cylinder, scale it and move slightly below the head. As you can see, for some reason my model turned out to be slightly offset from the central axis, so I have to fix it. I'm turning on a grid, then selecting the head, and let's turn on the snap tool. By the way, the hotkey for it is Shift plus Tab. Then select snap to increment. Unfortunately, when I tried to move the model, it didn't snap correctly. That's because we have to turn on the absolute grid snap. And now the head is perfectly centered. I'm scaling the cylinder for her neck and positioning it. Let's add a body. First, I will copy existing cylinder and scale it. Then, in edit mode, I will give to the cylinder a shape of a dress. I keep looking at the top left window with the concept art. Thanks to that camera, I can keep proportions quite close to my sketch. I'm closing the holes leaving support edges. I did that thinking that I will subdivide the dress, but I choose a more straightforward approach and remesh it. I forgot to turn on symmetry when I started sculpting. Now smoothing everything. Okay, now let's start shaping the body and the dress. I want to create a beautiful arch shape on the hemline. When you are working on a dress or a skirt, the most challenging part you will face, in my opinion, is how to make both the front and side look good, and also to leave an impression of the same length. That's really hard. We need to add more elements to the model. So I'm moving to the hair and creating a mask roughly in hair shape. Then use mask menu and then mask extract. As for now, I don't change anything in the pop-up menu. Playing with the thickness and offset values. I want the hair to continue inside the character's head a little bit. I'm doing this to ensure that there are no holes between her head and the hair on the modeling stage. With the Ctrl plus A hotkey, I will select scale to clean up her scale. In the Blender, it is vital to have a uniform scale on the objects you are trying to sculpt on. All the results may be unpredictable. Therefore, if you notice that your brushes are behaving strangely, then be sure to check the scale of the model. As always, smoothing, starting shaping her hair, and at that moment I realized that I was not very comfortable working with such a dark material, so I will make a lighter version. My hair had those little pinches at the bottom, so I'm remeshing it again and smoothing. I'm working with the main hair shapes, sculpting the back of her hair. Adding some volume to the hair. I want her hair to have a curl pattern near the face. Therefore, I begin to outline it roughly. I'm masking the curl part and assigning a face set to it. Later, I will be able to mask my brush's influence by face sets. It's really a useful feature. Piece by piece, she starts to look more like an attractive character. I am remeshing her neck and shaping it from every side. Now, when we have some hair, I can tweak her face a little. Just let me do it. I'm masking her nose and smoothing the mask with smooth mask option in the mask menu. I want to scale her nose. To achieve that, I will move the origin point closer to the nose. You can find the transform origins option in the options drop-down menu at the top right corner. Moving back to the sculpting mode and scaling her nose by pressing the S plus X hotkey. Refining shapes. Always check your model from different camera angles. I will say that in every video. It's really important. I am moving on to the legs. No secret here, just add another cylinder and scale it. Once again, remeshing and smoothing. With the pinch brush, I will make the cylinder thinner at the bottom, working on its shape with a move brush, and finally add a mirror modifier. Don't forget to use an object picker in mirror object, as we need an object with the origin point placed somewhere in the central axis of our character. Refining leg shape. To make arms, I will copy her legs and scale and place them roughly at the shoulders. I'm adjusting the character's arm placement a bit. I'm making more refined neck. Thank you. working on her face. Alright, let's add a hair strand. You know how it goes. I'm adding a path curve and a circle. Then, in path settings, find the geometry tab. Then bevel and use the object button. And with the object picker, select your circle. Finally, assign the hair material to it. I am moving her new hair strand closer to her face and forming a curly shape in the edit mode. I am scaling everything with the Alt plus S hotkey and extruding additional vertices by pressing the E button, working on the curl shape a little more. Let's add one more path and repeat all the previous steps. We will make antennas from this. Then I will assign a darker material to it, the one from the eyes. Over again, move to the edit mode and start shaping them vertice by vertice, scaling by the Alt plus S and extruding by the E hotkeys. I am shaping a character's hair to make some free space. Refining her head. And here I did something that I would call a mistake. I rotated antennas from the default position to slightly rotated. Don't do this! I left this as an example to show you that sometimes you want to add something unnecessary in the pursuit of beautiful sculpts. And by doing so, I've just made a ton of headache for the rigger. I'm sorry. So the best solution here would be to keep the antenna straight and rotate them during the animation stage. So please keep this in mind when making your models. Her eyes are still too small for me, so I scale them. refining shapes around the eyes. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time!